In the case of pipe and filter, we break the system into independently executing components called filters. The filters are connected together using a FIFO or first-in, first-out queue, and these queues are called pipes. So we have pipes connecting together the filters. Each of the filters is going to take a single input, which has become called the standard input, and it's going to produce a single output, which has now been called the standard output. The filters share the assumptions that the inputs and output consist of sequential files containing lines of ASCII characters. Can you think of a situation where you have a pipeline of filter components where it's non-ASCII?
I mean, I guess you could have, you could pipe together like Linux processes that are have binary output, but
yeah,
but wouldn't be useful.
Okay.
In terms of like a user interface, you wouldn't be seeing anything that might be useful.
Well, it turns out that in doing image processing,
okay,
you put various filters along the way to deal with the processing of the images. Mm-hmm. Also, in situations where there's sensor data and you want to filter out noise of certain kinds or select, you know, certain frequency bands and so on, it's binary data, but it's going through a filtering process. So this, although this does work in other situations, it's most familiar and most used in situations where there's text files. So as you've indicated, there's going to be filters having to do with circularly shifting and alphabetizing and reading things in and putting things out. And one of the essential elements of this particular approach to solving things is there's no common data storage elements. We're just passing the solution along as we go.